Hello, it's Sunday, the 26th of May, 2013, and I'm Martin Smith, financial analyst at UFXMarkets Trading Support Center with your week in review. Today, we'll discuss some of the major financial events of the past week and how they impacted the currency and commodity markets. The Canadian dollar fell against the US dollar for a third straight week, hitting a 12-month low against its North American counterpart. The Canadian dollar's slide against most of the major currencies was partly the result of lower US jobless claims and rising durable goods orders, both of which contributed to the widespread speculation among investors that the Federal Reserve will soon slow down the pace of its monetary stimulus program. On May 29th, outgoing Bank of Canada Governor Mark Carney will announce the interest rate decision. The Canadian dollar was last trading against the US dollar at 103.13, an increase of 0.12%. The pound fell against the euro for a fourth straight week in response to improving German business sentiment. And amid heightened speculation, the Bank of England will boost its stimulus program. Data released last week showed an unexpected drop in retail sales for April and slower than expected inflation. The pound was last trading against the euro at 0.8547, a decrease of 0.14%. In response to the increasing likelihood of the Federal Reserve beginning to phase out its bond buying program, futures traders raised bets the Japanese yen will hit its lowest level against the US dollar since July 2007. On Friday, the dollar index, which tracks the US dollar against the currencies of six trading partners in the United States, recorded its highest level since July 2010. The Japanese yen was last trading against the US dollar at 101.27, a decrease of 0.72%. The increasing likelihood of the imminent end to the Federal Reserve stimulus program pushed down the price of gold, which fell three times in 4 days as the precious metal lost its appeal as a safe haven asset. At the same time, many investors and market analysts predict that gold will climb next week, as Federal Reserve Chairman Ben Bernanke clearly indicated he will not scale back the pace of the stimulus program until the economy recovers. Gold was last trading at $1,386.40 an ounce, a decrease of 0.31%. In other news, crude oil capped its steepest weekly drop in over a month as durable goods orders rose in the United States, exacerbating investor concern about the imminence of an end to the Federal Reserve stimulus program. Oil plummeted after the U.S. Commerce Department announced that durable goods orders for April rose by 3.3%. Crude oil was last trading at the level of $94.15 a barrel, a decrease of 0.11%. Well, that's our summary of the financial headlines from the past week. We hope you've enjoyed this week's review, and you'll tune in again tomorrow morning as we kick off the new trading week with the latest top market news. Until then, be sure to log in to ufxmarkets.com for all your trading needs, and where your personal account manager is ready to answer all your questions. From all of us here at UFX Markets Trading Support Center, we wish you a successful trading week.